going to present to you the chapter 1 of the Introduction to Criminal Investigation, wherein at the end of each chapter, the student shall be able to, number 1, discuss the basic introduction of criminal investigation, to include its etymology. Number 2, compare and contrast the characteristics of investigation or investigator. Number 3, discuss the important historical background of investigation to include its personalities. And number 4, identify laws applicable in criminal investigation. So, at the end of this chapter class, I am expecting everyone that you are going to discuss, you are going to compare and contrast, you are going to identify laws. And of course, that is in relation to our study about criminal investigation. So, what is criminal investigation? So, I would like to remind everyone that in our recitation, quizzes, and exam, hindi nawawala ang definition of terms or terminology that you are going to define, no? So, again, I would like to remind that please review, memorize everything that we are going to tackle, because that is the basic foundation of knowledge. Without the basic foundation of knowledge, you cannot come up with the analyzing situation or to analyzation. So, what is criminal investigation class? It is an art which deals with the identity and location of the offender and provide evidence of his guilt through criminal proceedings. So if you notice on the definition of criminal investigation, this deals with the identity and location of the offender. It means that before you are going to conduct your investigation, there is already a crime committed. So if there is a crime committed, then that's the time that an investigator will pursue his investigation about the crime committed. And one thing that he could do is, that is based on the definition, he would identify and locate the offender. So, hahanapin mo, maghanap ka, sino ba ang gumawa ng krimen? Diba? Yan naman ang una nating tatanungin eh. Kung may nangyari, sino ang gumawa? Kung may nagnakaw, sino ang nagnakaw? Diba? Kung may pumatay, namatay, sino ang pumatay? And, kapag na-identify mo na kung sino, you need to provide evidence of his guilt. Okay, di ba? So, hindi pwedeng ituturo mo na lang yung isang tao na mukhang criminal. Hindi ganon. Kailangan mayroon kang batayan. You have the evidence pointing that person na sinasabi mo na ikaw yung gumawa ng krimen. And that will be proven through criminal proceedings. And that, pag sinabi natin criminal proceedings, yan na yung court trial, in short. Okay, di ba? So, that is criminal investigation. Now, the question is, when to investigate? No? Kailan ba mag-i-investigate ang isang police or ang mga law enforcer natin? The police officer initially conduct investigation when one of the following occur. Number 1, of course, nandyan ang complaint filed. Merong reklamo. May nagreklamo. Just like, for example, sinabi nila, may nag-tip na, sir, meron pong naninigarilyo ng marijuana doon. May nagtatanim ng marijuana doon. Okay, di ba? Sir, binugbog po ako. Sir, pinatay nila or tinutukan nila ng kutsilyo, baril, pinagtangkaan ang buhay, whatsoever. And that is under number one, complaint filed. Okay, number 2, crime committed or crime is in progress, nangyayari na. Ibig sabihin, ng ongoing, no, kasalukuyang nangyayari ang krimen, no? Sa number 1, usually tapos na kasi yan eh, naganap na. Ang number 2 naman, nangyayari pa lang. Halimbawa, no, nag-aaway, nagbubugbugan, nagtatagaan, no, o may kutsilyong dala yung nag-aaway. Okay, so yan, report ninyo. Alam nyo ngayon, ang dali na lang mag-report sa kapulisan nating, one text away na lang yan, no? Message mo lang, marireceive na nila yung complaint mo. And number 3, drug-related offense. O yan, baka may kakilala kayong tulak ng droga dyan. Nagbebenta ng mga marijuana, nagbebenta ng shabu, no? O yan. And number 4, traffic accident. Number 5, operation of organized crime. Yung mga sindikato natin, later on, we will discuss that in under police intelligence. And number 6, suspect is under arrest and detention. O nahuli mo na, of course, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yan. You are going to establish probable cause para sa ganon, yung kaso ay mapunta sa korte. And number 7, suspect is at large or fugitive from justice. Yan yung continuation nito or isa sa papag-aralan natin. So, in here, what are the kinds of criminal investigation? Yung nabanggit natin kanina, yung last two, ito kasi yung nasa mga module natin, no? So, inas-is ko na lang na ganito. So, number 1, when the suspect is under arrest and detention, pag hinuli mo siya, pag nahuli na, bakit mo hinuli? Anong dahilan bakit mo siya hinuli? So yan ang papatunayan mo, iimbestigahan mo, magga-gather ka ng mga witness, evidence laban sa kanya, di ba? So number 2 naman is when the suspect is at large o kaya ay fugitive from justice. Pag sinabi nating at large, may nangyaring krimen pero hindi pa nahuhuli kung sino yung gumawa ng krimen. Ibig sabihin, yan ay at large. Ang fugitive from justice naman ay nahuli mo kaya lang tumakas. Kaya nga ang other term ng fugitive from justice is escape prisoner. So dito, kapag yung isang suspect, o sabihin na natin na criminal, no? Eh tumakas, kailangan pa ba ng warrant of arrest sa kanya? Take note, the general rule for you to arrest a person is there must be a valid warrant of arrest. Without the valid warrant of arrest, you cannot arrest a person. But there is an exception to that rule. And one is if the person to be arrested is an escape prisoner. So wala na, no need for a warrant of arrest, no? Kaya na lang pagdating sa at large, no, yung hindi pa nahuhuli. Okay, hindi mo pa nga nahuhuli yung tao, no? So, kailangan ba ng warrant of arrest? Yes, kailangan ng warrant of arrest kung sino man yan, no? Yan ang pinagkaiba niyan. So, by the way, pag sinabi nating at large, ha, means the suspect is not under arrest or detention, not being a wanted person in the eyes of the law, and therefore cannot be lawfully arrested without a warrant. That is the definition. Remember the definition. And while fugitive from justice, this is obtained when an individual who, after having committed a criminal offense, leaves the jurisdiction of the court where such crime has taken place or hides within such jurisdiction to escape prosecution. So that is the definition of fugitive from justice. Now, the general rule is that in all criminal investigation or proceedings, probable cause must well establish. Yan ha, probable cause. Without probable cause, a police cannot arrest a person nor avail the issuance of warrant of arrest. O kaya ay search warrant. Importante ang probable cause. Ano ba yung probable cause na yan? What is mean by probable cause? Pag sinabi nating probable cause, it means a facts and circumstances that would endanger or engender a well-grounded belief that a crime has been committed and the person to be arrested committed it. Diba? So yan, patunay yan na talagang siya ang gumawa ng krimen. Kung may mga ebidensya ka, matibay na ebidensya, in short, meron kang probable cause laban sa kanya. Eh kung wala, puro chismis lang nakuha mong ebidensya, oops, teka muna. Kukwestiyonin ka ni prosecutor. Is that a probable cause? Sasabihin, tatanungin niya sa'yo. Pag hindi mo alam ang definition ng probable cause, baka tatanungin mo pa, ano ba yun, attorney? Ano ba yun, prosecutor? Ano ba ang probable cause? Baka isampal pa niya yung papel sa muging mo. No? So, that is the definition of probable cause. Now,